Creatine is one of the most popular fitness supplements in the world, with tons of data documenting its performance-enhancing benefits. Being so popular also means asking a lot of questions about it. So in this video, we'll quickly go over 5 of those questions people commonly ask about taking creatine. Number 1. Is creatine safe? For healthy adults, based on the research, creatine supplementation is generally safe. Now, it can cause water retention, especially early on, but that does not pose much of an issue outside of managing your weight. Creatine does, however, increase levels of creatinine. If you have kidney issues, it might be wise to consult with your doctor about creatine, even though there is short-term data suggesting it is safe. And if you're wondering, creatine is an amino acid compound and not a steroid. Number 2. When should you take creatine? Although there's a lack of data on the dangers of taking creatine in adolescents, there's also a lack of data on its safety. For this reason, for ages 18 and under, I suggest taking creatine only under proper adult supervision. As for timing creatine, some limited data suggests it is better to take it immediately after workout, but by far the most important creatine timing factor is simply taking it consistently, be it before or after your workout, or any other time of the day. Number 3. Which type of creatine is best? Creatine monohydrate has by far the most evidence of its benefits, and other creatine forms have never demonstrated to be superior to it. It's also among the most inexpensive forms of creatine, so save your money and stick to the stuff that just works, and that's monohydrate. Number 4. Do you need to load creatine? It takes roughly 3 to 4 weeks to fully saturate the muscles with creatine when taking the standard 3 to 5 gram daily dose. On the other hand, it only takes about 7 days when using a creatine loading phase of about 20 grams per day for the first 5 to 7 days. This 2 to 3 week difference is not a lot of time, to be honest, especially when thinking of the big picture of long-term fitness. But if this difference is important to you for whatever reason, then you can give loading a shot. For athletes, you might even consider multiple loading phases to keep your muscles consistently saturated. And number 5 of some of the most common creatine questions is, does creatine cause hair loss? Much of the speculation about creatine and hair loss stems from a 2009 study that showed creatine supplementation can increase DHT, which is a hormone connected to certain hair loss patterns. However, this data was never replicated, and similar hormones like testosterone, which is a precursor to DHT, has not shown to be influenced with creatine supplementation. As far as the science goes, there is no indication that taking creatine directly causes hair loss. Yet, as much as I like science and data, I would be remiss if I did not mention that over the years, I've noticed that hair loss after taking creatine is one of the most prevalent personal complaints I've ever seen for a so-called fitness myth. I've personally never experienced it, as you can see, but I do think it's sensible for anyone concerned about it that you do a bit of experimenting of your own. Science might say otherwise, but it will be you deciding whether that copious 900-ounce container of hair gel will ever be used again. If you want to learn more about creatine, then check out my other creatine video explaining what creatine is and how to take it. That's it for this one. I hope you found it useful, and if you still have questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments. Other than that, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a hairy thumbs up and share it with your creatine-loving friends. Subscribe for more. As always, thank you for watching, and don't forget to get your protein.